Yeah, it's quite obvious what's in there, so let's just unbox this. Okay, now I'm just destroying this expensive cardboard box.
So, this is the bulk Velomobile. This is provided by Jan and the team from velomobileworld.com. This is not mine, but I can keep this for a while, so there will be more bulk content coming to my channel. Stay tuned.
Ooh, nice stickers. Okay, so looks like they have thrown in additional racing hood for me. So this is the standard racing hood with Lexan visor. This kind of visor. And this is the motorbike visor version.
I also have the combi lid, but they sent it separately. It arrived few weeks earlier.
And looks like they haven't mounted the mirrors yet. So I guess that's the first thing I have to do. What are all these things?
I have probably something extra. Like, for example, this looks like the adjustment tool for the front wheel alignment. Here's probably, let's see what's in here. Yes, these are the adjustment part for the neck rest. Two different sizes. So this should be easy to adjust to different size of people. And I'm going to test that, of course. This is probably for the seat. I guess it goes somewhere over here. I got some spare parts and tools. Yeah, this is good. Seat is pretty lightweight. Nice carbon fiber seat. I guess here are the mirrors. And I'm supposed to find the best spot for these. And drill holes in here. I have no idea where's the good spot. Armrests. What else? There's probably a spare battery and a charger, I guess. What else we can see here? Lot of dust. Okay, so these tools and parts are part of the extra maintenance package. And these adapters are part of the ambassador package. The extra battery and armrest are here because I ordered them myself. So none of these are normally included with the Velomobile. You will get one set of adapters which will fit your size. Both of these packages you can buy separately. If you don't have any tools, I would recommend you to get this maintenance package if it's not too expensive, because it includes some special tools and spare parts which might be difficult to find from your local bike shop.
Okay, in here should be something interesting. There should be, yeah, air suspension. This is going to be interesting. So this is basically same kind of air spring that there's on my Quattro Velo. And there you can put some pressure in it. Here's the main switch. And here under there is a switch for the interior light. And now the lights are on. Yeah.
Oh, cool black reflectors.
Yeah, cool.
Nice tail lights. Flashing on daylight riding mode.
And if I put the high beam on,
now this goes more brighter and these are steady. Lift handle,
air intake, the air comes from here and there's an adjustment. You can adjust how much air there's going to be.
This visor, this is going to be interesting to test. What's in here?
Okay, Shimano rear derailleur Deore. Here we can see the air suspension. And the shock absorber is there. Yeah.
The bulk seems to have decent ground clearance. This one has the soft springs mounted. With sportier hard springs, the ground clearance might be smaller. The indicator beeper makes weird noise. Turns out it was rattling around inside the dashboard. I tried to fix it, but it didn't get much better. Okay, then I quickly check that everything is in working condition. There's a good checklist on Velomobile World's website, which you can follow to do the inspection before the first ride. Then was time to set the seating position and fine-tune the bottom bracket position. To mount the mirrors, there's good instruction video on the Velomobile World's YouTube channel. I leave a link in the description. So basically, use a double-sided tape to test the position first. You should always check with the racing hood which you are going to use, that you can still see the mirror with your both eyes. This is especially important with this motorbike visor, because the field of view with this one is slightly narrower than with the standard hood. It's good to measure carefully that the position of the mirrors will be symmetrical. The drilling is always the scariest part. Then was time for the test ride. The very first thing I noticed when climbing in was that how much there's room around my shoulders. This feels actually as spacious as a Quest, but on the other hand, the front of the Velomobile, where your legs are, feels quite cramped and tight, just like the Milan SL was.
Okay, the first test ride with the bulk. Looks like I can test how well this works in the race.
Okay, some first impressions about the bulk Velomobile after about 30 kilometers. Let's do this quickly because it's raining. Okay, so first of all, it rides quite well. It feels very light. But there's still some adjustments to do. I ended up using this headrest adapter, size small. I maybe like this better than the medium size, but I probably have to test the medium size more. This front shifter, I don't like this at all. This mounting in here, it's bad. I don't like this. It's in very bad position. I have to rest my hand here, and it feels very awkward to have this here. The rear shifter, this is okay. This is same that I had in the Milan. I still need to adjust the brakes. I feel that it's pulling to the left. Also the steering is pulling to the left a little bit. I have to figure out if there's something I can adjust. This motorbike helmet type visor, this works quite well on rain. There's little, when you close this, there's little bit of gap here, so some water will spray inside, but also the airflow will keep this lower part of the visor clear, like you can see here. But the side windows, these will fog, as you can see. It wasn't surprising. That's going to block the view, the side. It's not a problem when you're riding on the road, but it will be a problem on intersections. So then you probably have to lift this little bit to see to the sides. The service hatch, this has the same problem than with the Milan. It's leaking a little bit. So there will be some water dropping inside. The air vent here on the front, this is excellent. I like this very much. I show you where it comes out. There's this adjustable hole. There's coming quite a lot of air from this hole. It's much better than what was in the Milan. And you can adjust it with this. You can change the position like this. If you want to block it completely, you can put it like this. Now there will be no airflow. But this is definitely one of the best features of this Velomobile. This Naka duct, on the other hand, this doesn't feel so effective. Because that one is so effective, so that's why this doesn't feel so effective, and also because you can very easily lift this visor up. So you can get very good airflow to your face very quickly. So this also I like very much this type of visor. I have the additional luggage compartments over there. Those ones over there and one other side as well. These ones. This means that there's very little room for your shoes and it's very difficult to remove your shoes from the pedals. I have to bend my ankle to very, very uncomfortable position so I can clip off from the pedals. So my advice would be at this point that if you don't need these, luggage compartments, don't get them. The riding position actually feels quite good. This very comfortable seat. I think that this time I somehow got the bottom bracket position right at the first try. So I probably don't have to adjust it anymore. But I do have to try the different size headrest. That I'm going to test later. I really like these black reflectors. These are very cool looking. And Jan has put here some advertisement. There's some exit holes for the airflow. And the airflow inside is actually pretty good. So I think these are working very well. I think that I also got the mirror position right at the first time. You have to be careful when you mount the mirrors that you can see the mirror, because the A-pillar here will block the view if you put the mirror too much back here. But okay, subscribe for more bulk content. See you later. Bye.